What is up, guys? We are live here in my studio talking about some Reds. I'm just going to give it a minute and let a few people sign on before we get started. All right, we've got a few coming on. Cool, more and more. All right, awesome. Well, I'll do a quick intro. Let me see if I can turn this camera around. Where is it at? Wait. There we go. Hey, how's it going? All right. Hey, guys. So we are here at my studio. We're going to be talking a little bit about working with Reds and some of the new colors that we've got here with Joico. Hi. I'll be waving. Hey, Michelle. Sorry guys, I get distracted really easy, so I'll have a lot of squirrel moments, which is why I'm going to pass this off to my lovely wife, who's standing over there. She's going to be holding this throughout the duration of the, hey, other Michelle, throughout the duration of this. But before we got started into the actual technique and everything that I'm going to be doing and showing, I wanted to talk a little bit about some of the colors that we have here at Joico. Some of my favorite ones, and we actually just launched these. Hey, Courtney. So some of my favorite ones, we just launched these recently. If you haven't had a chance, you can actually go on to Joico's YouTube, and there's a video on there from my good friend Mark Maletti, and he does a demonstration of his ribbon lights using the NRGs. So the NRGs, in my opinion, are probably the perfect balance of red that you would want in the hair. I mean, in my opinion, like this is like your one-stop shop for a perfect red. If any of you know who Julianne Hough is, which hopefully you do, and you go onto Joico's Instagram, you'll actually be able to see a picture where she recently transitioned from blonde to a gorgeous rich red that Rihanna Capri did using our Lumishine collection. And I wanted to talk a little bit about that. We actually have a great representation of that right here, and our lovely model. So this is what's a little bit different here is obviously the color is a little bit different from what you'd see with what happened with Julianne Hough. So she's got a little bit of regrowth, and we've got half the head done. Well, not even half the head. It went off of her part line and tried to get some of it done because she's got masses of hair. There's so much hair here that you'll see once we get into it. But I wanted everyone to get a good understanding of the placement and the technique. So I got part of it done so that way I can actually go through and show the technique and the placement of how I created this particular look. But there is something with the placement to where we're going to add a lot of dimension. I feel like reds, and I see my friend Sherry Rattay's on, and she talks so much about dimension in the hair. And she's actually an educator here with Joico. That's right down the road from me. But we talk about dimension a lot. So we didn't want to make it just a single note. I'm going to take you over here and show you some of my formulas. So we've got three different colors going on here. And then a fourth surprise in the corner. Because if you know me and you know my work, hey, Sherry, and you know my work, you know I have to have some color intensity. So in order to create some really vibrant pops in there, but something that's still going to blend and kind of go with the natural reds that we're creating, I decided to throw in a little color intensity red. So most of the formula that we're going to be doing, I'll say it now, and we'll try to maybe put it in the captions later just in case anyone has questions about it. So her base, her natural base level is a level 7. Okay, it looks a little bit darker because she's so blonde right now, but she is a natural level 7, so I wanted to keep her close to her natural so that when that regrowth comes in, it doesn't have too harsh of a line, even though we're obviously changing the tone of the hair. So we went with a 7 NRG straight on with a little bit of 5 RR for just that little added depth. Now, if you don't know anything about Lumishine, this is our pre-blended color line. So most people know Joico for this, which is our Vero K-Pak color. This is our True Tone color, all of these colors are meant to be mixed and blended with other colors, whereas our Lumashine collection is quick and easy to use, 2 to 3 colors max in your formulas. And what makes it great is that you can really just kind of go straight on with one color straight out of the box. So I went on with that 7NRG, like I said, at the root with a little bit of 5RR using 10 volume, because we are strictly depositing. So just to keep it nice and uniform, for the rest of it, what I'm doing for those pops is actually, we've got some of our formulas over here. So I included a little bit of the CCs. So the CC and the RR are some of the other, and the VVs. Okay, so we've got, these are the different shades within Lumashine that are pure tone. Okay, so they don't have that natural base. If you notice with most of them, you've got the NC. So it starts with a natural, the NRV, again, starting with a natural and then transitions into your tone. Okay, so these ones, your RRs, your VVs, your CCs are your true tone colors. And that's what I decided to use, again, just to add a little bit more vibrancy into some of these, some of the colors that we're using. So in some of these mesh in here, we've got a formula, this formula here, which is a 6cc and 7NRG. So that's just going to be a little bit brighter than our base formula, which, like I said, is the 7NRG and the 5R, a little bit of 5RR. So probably 3/4 of the 7NRG and just 1/4 of the 5RR. And then our all-over base formula is actually 8NRG and 7NRG mixed together with a tiny bit of 6RR. Okay, so we're not shifting those tones around too much. We want it to look very natural and blended. So we're staying within like 1 to 2 levels from the lowest point to the highest point. We just want a really nice, rich, dimensional red. And we'll talk a little bit more about some of the maintenance and some of these things that we've got over here as we go on. But she has so much hair that I am going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to pass the phone off to my wife. She reminded me I was supposed to do an intro of myself, which I completely forgot. So I'll just say, in case you guys don't know who I am, which I'm sure there's a lot of you that don't. My name is Ricardo Santiago. I am a global artist with Joico. And I also, here, I'm going to pass it off to her and let her hold it.
Okay.
So I work behind the chair. I feel like I'm at a show doing like my standard intro. I work behind the chair 6 to 7 days a week. And that's not an exaggeration. Like sometimes it's a little bit ridiculous. We're trying to tone that down. This year we're actually cutting back to like 5 days a week because it was getting a little crazy. But it doesn't feel like work when you really love what you're doing, and I genuinely love what I do. So getting to do things like this, getting to educate, getting to meet everyone everywhere that I go and go to do the shows, it's a lot of fun. It's a big passion of mine. And I share that with some amazing people on the team with the company, with Joico. Always getting to go and do these shows and work with my friends. It doesn't feel like work. So if you ever see me at a show or you happen to attend, please make sure that you come and say hi. Or if we're friends on Instagram, or even if we're not, we should be. My handle is stylist Ricardo Santiago. So you can always reach out. I have a lot of people that reach out, ask questions, leave comments. I love to engage with everyone. For me, the industry is all about just making some new friends. So we can all be friends and maybe hang out at a show. I don't know. So I'm gonna get started because she, like I said, has a lot of hair. So we clipped it away kind of based off of her part. She says that she naturally parts her hair just off to the side. So you see it's obviously not a center line that we've parted off to, but just kind of working off of where her natural part line is. Now, knowing that, it's kind of important when it comes to the sectioning of the technique that I'm gonna do. I actually am taking a few tips from my friends, Mark Luddy and Zoe Carpenter, who are diehard Lumashine users and just fantastic colorists if you've never seen their stuff. So Mark does a technique that he calls ribbon lighting. Like I mentioned before, he did a video on our YouTube where he demonstrates that using the NRGs. And Zoe does this thing where she calls them skin lights, where she's basically using this center panel here, just behind the ear, knowing that that's really going to be the focal point. When this hair falls, the one thing that's always popping through is what's sitting just in front of that shoulder. And what sits above that shoulder is everything right in between here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is we're going to do a little bit of color melting, because I color melt everything, if you didn't already know that.
And allow me, can we just confirm, I have a few people saying they can't hear. If you can hear, can you let us know? And if you can't, maybe just a couple other people, let us know too. But Ricardo, you can continue and...
Yeah, can you, I want to make sure that they can all hear. So just getting into the technique, you can see we've got that little bit of regrowth, okay? So with the regrowth, I'm going to use that same form. That's why we're going on with 10 volume, because like I said, we're just depositing. We're not trying to lift or do anything to influence beyond her natural base level. We're just going to work with what she has, and we're going to try to fill and deposit at the same time. So if you know about working with blondes, when you're this blonde and you're trying to get back down into a rich tone, you obviously would want to fill this first. So a good formula for me, I always like to see what level I'm trying to take it to. Go-to is usually something with like a natural copper and our Lumishine Demi Liquid. So if you look right over here, we actually have some of those Demi Liquids right there. The 7 and the 8 NC, those are some of my favorite ones to use for that pre-pigmenting before we go back in. But I really wanted to showcase the versatility and the depth and the vibrancy that you get using the Lumishine straight on. So I have experimented with this before with a client that actually was very blonde, just like this. And we just posted her on my Instagram, so if you want to see what it looks like, you can actually go on there and take a look. I think she's within the last 3 or 4 posts. But she went from blonde to a beautiful, rich, like autumn red. And I had so many people reaching out and asking for formulas and all this other stuff. And really, all I did was go on using the NRG series. And that was it. There was nothing else in that formula. But you'll see how beautiful and rich it ends up being.
Someone asked for the formulas. We'll go ahead and post those in the comment section below, as well as when we make the post of the photos of the after.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll definitely make sure. So we're not obviously not going to be able to see the final result here by the end of this live, just because she has so much hair. There's no way possible to get through all of this and be able to style it out and be able to show it off. So what we'll do is we'll make sure that it's on, the results will probably be on Joico's Instagram, they'll be on my personal Instagram. And if Cosmo Prof is feeling crazy and they wanna post it on theirs, it could be on theirs too. No pressure, girls. See how I put them on the spot? Now they have to post it, they have to share my work.
Hey Donna, to answer your question, this is using all Joico, specifically Joico Lumishine.
Yeah, so we're using the Lumishine NRG series with a few little additives. Again, the base formula is a 7 NRG with a little bit of 5 RR mixed in there, okay? And what I'm doing, this is the way that I typically apply a root formula when I'm trying to create a shadow. So I usually go kind of at a horizontal until I get to right where the occipital is, and then I'll start shifting and grabbing a little bit more of a diagonal. And as I grab that diagonal, working my way up, I'm gonna keep working in that diagonal, but creating a more steep diagonal. So it's always going diagonal back. And you'll see that as we keep working up, it'll eventually shift into a vertical parting. And what that does is it really just diffuses that line out. If you've been to any of the shows that I've taught at, I always try to show this because shadow rooting is such a big thing right now. And if you do it this way, I can guarantee that every time you're not gonna end up with a harsh line. And something else that you can do is when you're going in and you're doing that application, is once you've applied that color, just turn your brush from the horizontal to a vertical and just give it a few little peaks and valleys, okay? So that what that's doing is also breaking it up, so you don't end up with that harsh line, just like you're gonna, like you see there with her natural base.
Somebody has a question. Does it matter if you start at the bottom or at the top?
So I personally, when I'm doing a shadow root like this, I like starting at the bottom. The reason for that is that, like I said, I'm pivoting as I'm working my way up. I'm actually following the curve of the head. Now you can do that from the top down, but I feel like it's just a lot easier if you're doing it from the bottom up. And notice that I'm able to have a little bit more control because I'm holding the hair out of the way as I work my way through my sections here. So I personally just think it's a little bit easier if you're working from the bottom up versus from the top down, because then you also have to worry, if you're working from the top down, about color getting on the ends that you don't want to get on those ends, because there's not really a way to move it up and keep it out of that color.
Another question from Emma. Thanks for that question, Stephanie. Emma asks, what volume of developer are you using with your formulas?
So this is all with 10 volume. So everything that I'm doing is 10 volume. And now you could use 5 volume if you want to. I like to keep the volumes all the same. So because we're depositing only, I'm going to go on to 10 the entire time.
Good question.
Yeah, great questions. And feel free to ask along. Angela will make sure that she gets to those, and we'll answer them as accurately as possible. So for this technique, it is a lot easier to work in a quadrant. So even though we've already done that side, you can see I still section off the front half, and I'll just work in a similar fashion all the way up. It's a lot easier too, because once you get onto this side and this front quadrant, you'll be able, your diagonals will end up just kind of matching in line, and you'll fall right into place. So that way you're always working the same way.
What is the formula that you're using? Again, we'll go ahead, just to avoid repeating too many times, we'll go ahead and post those up in the comments as well as on the posts that are made on social media after the live session concludes. But thank you for your question.
Just in case, I'll go ahead and say it anyway.
Oh, he's so much nicer than me.
Just because I know it's just easier to get it. So it's this is 7-NRG. 7-NRG mixed with a little bit of 5-RR. Okay, now the her hair, I'll tell you, the ratios were a little skewed because she has so much hair, right? So the first half that I did, which was really only like maybe 35 to 40% of her hair, because this is obviously the heavier half. In the first half, I mixed 5 ounces just for that base formula, and I went through all 5 ounces. So this is 6.5 ounces just for her root, and I'll probably go through a total of close to 30 ounces of color on her hair, because there's so much of it. And I'm using an extra large, an extra wide brush. It just makes it so much easier when you're trying to work through this much hair, and the sections are a little bit wider. It just helps me to work a little faster. So these are from my friends over at Color Track. But you see the shape that we're starting to create here, how it almost kind of creates an arch, right? So what that's doing is it's actually following the curve of the head. Okay, so it's deeper on the center curved points, and it's gonna stay a little bit more shallow towards the top. And what that does is it just keeps diffusing that root color, so that way every time I keep working my way up, every section that I take, it's gonna soften that line out, and you won't end up with any harsh lines as you work your way up.
Somebody asks, just to confirm, is she a level 10 or higher to start?
She's a level 10. She's definitely a level 10.
Well, pre-lightened level 10.
Yeah, pre-lightened level 10 with a natural level 7 root.
Okay, here's another question from Rachel. She said, how do you handle this? A heavily highlighted client wants to be all dark with a balayage. Tell them no.
There's a lot of prayer involved in that. I personally when I work with that kind of a client, and I do that at shows sometimes, we actually had a perfect example of that happen at the last show in DC at the Mid-Atlantic Fashion Focus, where we had a color correction. The girl was heavily highlighted with a lot of bands. She had about 1.5 to 2 inches of regrowth, and then she had like a bright, so 1.5 to 2 inches of regrowth, and then like a bright orange band, and then a band of like really dark for about 2 inches, and then kind of like this weird orangey color through the mids and ends. What I did was I knew that we were gonna have to tackle that in steps, and I also knew that she didn't belong in that kind of color. Like, she wasn't supposed to be that light. So I pre-pigmented her. We went in with trying to remember what our formula was. I know I used chrome, so I used verochrome, which is our cream demi. It's our acidic base cream demi color in our True Tone series. Okay, so I used, I believe it was a G6, and I don't remember what the other one was, but it was definitely a G6 with something else, another warm tone that I mixed up, maybe an RC6 or an RC8. So I went in with that first, we filled her hair, and then we went back through afterwards and deposited our dark, and then after that, then we went back through and did a balayage over the top of that. Because it was freshly colored, it seemed to lift out a little bit easier. It's not necessarily going to be the case every time, but her results actually were very nice. It was a beautiful, rich, kind of a chestnut brown with some caramel balayage pieces, which really suit her skin tone a lot better than what she came in with.
And you can see that. Ricardo actually posted that on his Instagram a few posts back, so you can check out the results on that. Hope that answered your question. We have another question from Judy. She asks, she notices that you didn't fill her hair. Will the Lumishine color fill on its own?
Yep, so that's actually what one of the first things that I was addressing was, instead of filling the hair, which normally is what I would do, I decided to go straight on with the Lumishine color. Again, it's a pre-blended color line, so it has a little bit more pigment, and so I'm able to kind of just work through it, and it'll fill at the same time as it's depositing. So you can see over here that how deep and rich that color is already. And so this is the same formula that we're gonna put through the mids and ends here. And when it's done, you'll be able to see in the photos how nicely it fills in that hair without necessarily having to pre-pigment. Now, most of the time I would recommend though pre-pigmenting, but I wanted to showcase how well our colors work even without having to do that. When you're working with reds and coppers and things like that, you have to understand that pre-pigmenting, usually you always want to do that when you're working towards a deep color, because whenever you lift these colors out, and we're going to get a little nerdy, a little color theory here, but when you're lifting colors out, obviously you're taking away those levels of pigment that are in there. So depending on what level you want to get to, that's how much pigment you need to put back in. So when you're going from a dark brown to a blonde, then you've bypassed the red, the orange, the yellow phase, right? So you need to put that yellow, orange, and red back in order to then be able to fill it. So you need that warm tone to anchor whatever color you're gonna put over the top. Because I'm working with a warm tone right now, I've done it and I've seen it to where I've tried it with filling and without filling, and then it works fine both ways when I'm using the NRG series. So that's why I didn't.
Hope that answers your question. Thank you guys for sending in questions. You can feel free to ask questions about what Ricardo's doing right now. He is doing his shadow root for the melt portion of his color. But you are free to ask any questions about Joyico that you might have as well.
Yeah, I'll do my best to answer as many as I can. There's a lot that I still probably won't be able to answer, but if you have any other questions, like I said, reach out. And if I don't know the answer, I will find out who does and then get you the answer.
Awesome.
Okay, so again, I'm starting at a slight horizontal, and then I'm going to pivot up to a diagonal back. So I'll start taking that diagonal. Now, it's a little tricky because she has this fringe So let's just get this out of the way.
That's our beautiful model, Callie. So thanks for being with us today. She is going to be a gorgeous redhead, so we're excited to see her results. If she didn't do it today, I was going to do it, but she took my spot, so.
She's a brave soul. We've never met Callie before today. She just showed up.
Oh, here's a good question from Katrina. She said, have you used this formulation on 100% gray?
Ooh, I have not used this on 100% gray, no. I will say that with that, I would still put in another one of our formulas that does cover 100% gray, which is going to be the N or the NWV series that's going to stay in that warm tone, just to make sure that you get the coverage that you need for that. I would be curious to see what it would look like if somebody went straight on with the NRG. Again, having that natural base, you're going to get some gray coverage, but I don't think it's going to give you 100% gray coverage. So I would actually love to see if somebody did that, if they could send me a photo of what it looked like with just the NRG.
Okay, good question. We have another one, two. And people are voting me to go red, so I might really think about it.
You shouldn't have said anything.
I know. I'm going to get a bunch of DMs. Stephanie Roach asks, have you played with the new cream demis?
Ooh. So, that actually, I was saving it for the end. Thanks for ruining it, Stephanie. So, our demi creams are launching, are getting ready to launch, and we actually have some of them right over there, so if Angela wouldn't mind.
I don't mind.
So those are our new demi creams. What's great about those is they are obviously, like we said, a demi cream color, but these are an alkaline demi cream, which my buddy Jacob Kahn is going to be so excited about, because he's been dying for a great demi cream that's an alkaline base. So now we literally have everything that you could want with the Joico family. As far as your colors, we have our True Tone series for the OGs who've been around for a while, who love that Pure Tone. We have our Pure Tone Acidic Demi Cream. Now we also have our Liquid Demis, which we launched with Lumishine. We have our new shades with Lumishine, which we're continuing to expand that color line. And part of that expansion is the new Demi Creams that just came out, or actually are just coming out later this year. So I have played with them. I absolutely love them. You will get, you can get on a level 6 and darker 100% gray coverage with our demi creams. For anything lighter than that, you can get great, perfect gray blending. I don't know. There's too many good things to say about it that honestly, I just would say that if you have an opportunity to get your hands on them, just get your hands on them and try, and you will thank me for that later.
Okay, we've got a couple questions coming in. Hopefully I won't miss anybody. Mariah Hall asks, what did you use to pre-lighten her, and did you tone her afterwards or no?
Okay, so Mariah, she actually came to us just like this. I had never touched her hair before putting this red color on. So she was pre-lightened elsewhere, and when was the last time you got your roots touched up?
Like a month ago.
Probably about 4 weeks, a month ago.
Okay, which explains just that quarter inch of regrowth.
She is the perfect response to a model call.
Yeah.
And she's very nice too, so that's always awesome.
Except for she has so much hair.
Yeah.
So much.
Okay, so let's see, the next one is, I'm not sure what that meant. If I miss a question, it's because I might not understand it. Somebody asked, what is the NRG he mentions? That is the Joico Lumishine line.
Yep, it's a natural red gold is what the NRG stands for.
Good thing you know that. Okay, another question comes in from Hong Lee. When she comes back for a touch-up, what do you recommend?
So to touch up her root formula, actually I would keep the same formula. Now, obviously, she's going to be fading a little bit. We know that the hardest colors to maintain are reds, right? Reds, blondes are the two hardest colors to achieve and to achieve properly, and the maintenance on them is also the most difficult. So in order to keep up with it, I will be sending her home with our color-infused red shampoo and conditioner. which we have over there. And then also, if she wanted to, just to deepen her color or brighten her color in any spots if it starts to fade out, I love with reds to send them home with a Joico color butter in the red. So if we want, we can go ahead and show that. And the color butter is basically, it's a deep conditioning mask with color depositing capabilities. So it will deposit that vibrant red without actually using color. So it's a deep conditioning mask, like I said. You put it on for 5 minutes. You can put it on damp, you can put it on dry, it doesn't matter. Just shampoo first, put that on, and then rinse it out. That's all you have to do is rinse. A lot of people think you have to shampoo again after, but you don't. It's literally just a rinse out because, like I said, it's conditioner. I say that 3 times because I've been told if you say things 3 times, people remember that. And with that color butter, that's probably the number one question that I get is, oh, do you shampoo it out afterwards? Because people forget that I keep saying it's a deep conditioning mask. So, yeah.
Good question. If she wanted to transition back to blonde, what would your approach be?
She's SOL.
Oh, she's...
No, I'm just kidding.
Shot out of luck.
She's like, what? No. So if someone did want to transition back to blonde, and actually, perfect example of that is the client that we just posted on Instagram, I would probably just slowly start highlighting her back and explain that, you know, it's not going to be, she's not going to go from red to silver, obviously, and she's not going to have a nice cool tone blonde when she's done, because the red pigment is going to hold into the hair really well, especially when using those NRGs. So the client that we posted on Instagram, that's on there now, that you would see go from that blonde to that red, then came back after retouching her red probably 3 or 4 times. She asked if she could start going back to blonde. So I said, okay, just understand that it's going to be a process and you're going to hit a few different shades of blonde on the way. You'll probably be like a gingery color, a coppery color. You know, there's different levels within that family that she's going to be living in. And she was okay with it. The first session, we actually got her a lot lighter than expected. I used Blonde Life and 20 volume on her, and she lifted up amazingly. So I just did everything in foil and toned her with a 9, half 9 and half 10 NWV just to continue to balance out the richness of what came out. And she ended up with actually a really pretty blonde that she's been wearing for a little while, like a kind of a honey blonde. And she should be due to come back here pretty soon for her next round of highlighting. I told her to give a couple of months in between just to let her hair recover from such a heavy highlighting process.
And that's what we did with me too, and I was ginger as well.
Yeah.
Okay, and Rachel, I see you've listed quite a bit of history and a little bit longer of, it seems like, better for a discussion. So if you wouldn't mind allowing Ricardo to message you back, or you can copy and paste that in a DM, I know he will answer that question a little bit more thoroughly. Let's see what else. Somebody said Lumishine DD cream, demi-permanent cream colors will launch May 1st. So there's the answer to that. And they are available pre-order through your Cosmoprof sales consultant, launching May 1st. Katrina Burkhart asks, alkaline shifts the base?
I haven't seen any shifting in anything that I've done, but I've only used it as a deposit using just 5 volume, which is what you're meant to do. But I haven't seen anything as far as shifting that base. So I've seen it happen with other demi colors, especially with other alkaline demi colors, but I have not seen that with ours. If anybody from our team is on right now that has seen that, maybe they could chime in, but I haven't experienced that myself.
Awesome. Okay, so we just have a lot of people praising color butter and sharing that there's 20 different shades that will launch with the demi creams. So that is awesome. Okay, so Ricardo's going to be just finishing up his shadow root here.
Yeah.
In a few more sections.
So you can see, like I said before, I'm continuing that diagonal back all the way up through this top, the top of the front quadrant. Okay. And once I get done applying all the way. Then I'm going to go back down to the bottom of the first quadrant, and we're going to start applying the all over color. Before I do that, I do want to show you what the sectioning is for this technique, just in case we run out of time and you're not able to see what that finished result looks like application wise. I want you to be able to at least visualize and know how to alternate those formulas.
God bless you.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Thank you. So we're still just kind of stretching that root and softening it up a little bit as we go through. Again, I like to just churn that brush vertically and break those lines up a little bit more. Last couple pieces.
Is your mom's name Donna?
What?
Is your mom's name Donna? Yeah. No. Oh. I guess somebody said, oh my gosh, that's my daughter, but I'm guessing it's just a similarity is what I'm guessing. Like, did your mom sign on? That's precious. Hey, Keon.
That would be cute.
Hey, Keon. We've got Phil joining us. Yep. Phil's with us. Okay, so Katrina asks, why the preference for an alkaline base then?
I personally, I feel like it just depends on what you're trying to do. So that for better gray coverage, the alkaline is you're better suited with that. So I like to use that versus the acidic base for gray coverage. And it also gives for me, I like to use a demi whenever possible if I'm just depositing, just because it's just a more natural finish versus always going on with the more harsh permanent. But that's just my preference, to be honest with you.
I'm just gonna zoom in here so you can kind of see there's not a harsh line there.
Yeah, so we've kind of broken it up and usually goes from a little bit more shallow up in the front and then just kind of stretches and gets a little bit deeper as we work our way back and falls right in line with the same line working back towards that back, that rear section there. Now, for the sectioning of the technique, what I did on this side over here, and what I'll do is I'm actually going to work all the way up through until I get to this parallel, right? So as soon as my front quadrant meets the rear quadrant, all of this underneath is going to be one formula. So that's going to be our mids and ends formula, which is the one that I mentioned before. That's the 8 and 7 NRG combination with a little bit of 6RR. Okay, so that's going to be all of this underneath here. Okay, so I like to always have kind of that base showing and giving some depth from underneath. And then what I did was I came and found that center point. So because this is her part line, right, we're not gonna stay as low as we did on this side. We're gonna go a little bit higher because we have to match that same point on the other side for balance. So whereas over there, this was where I stopped and I did almost like a pyramid shape. So you're gonna take out like a rectangle shape here. Okay, and then above that, you're gonna take a triangle over the top. And those two bottom ones, you're gonna alternate your formula between our copper infused formula and then our red color intensity. So you'll alternate those. And then after that, then you're gonna put one more of your all around base for your bottom of the pyramid. And then you're gonna alternate all three formulas as you work your way up.
I have a really good question. This is one of my favorite ones. Are you using any Olaplex?
I am not using any Olaplex. Lumishine has a unique technology. Okay, so it's called Argiplex technology, and basically what it is your hair is made up of 19 amino acids. Okay, so in most of our Joico products, we have what's called our quadrumene complex, and that's basically replicating those 19 amino acids in the same order, which replicates the same as that human keratin protein that makes up the hair. Arginine is the largest molecule of those amino acids. So Argiplex has actually isolated that arginine and will use that to fill. So you're actually filling back in as it's processing, and it's gonna allow for deeper penetration with your color. So that's why for 99% of the color that I do, I don't use any bond additives, because I don't need it with Joico, and especially with the Archiplex.
Awesome, that's a good question.
Great question.
Phil joined us. He
has not very, allowed to ask questions.
He's very confident that her hair is going to look beautiful with other descriptive words.
Phil is allowed to say things, but no questions. Okay, so here's my base, right? So this is going to be the base of my pyramid, and you can see the placement of it, right? So her ears here were just a little bit off that hairline, just enough to where when this falls, it's going to kind of peek through the front of that hairline. And then I'm going to come up and take a triangle section over the top of that and let that fall right on top.
Just want to say thanks to everyone who is joining in, especially our friends, Phil, Keon, the Joico family, other educators, and students that are signed in. So thanks so much. And just be sure if we miss your question that you don't hesitate to ask it again or send a DM. Ricardo will be very happy to answer after the live as well. And you can also replay this live as well. And we will be posting after photos on all social media channels.
I'll be mostly happy. I won't be 100% happy answering all the questions, but I'll be mostly happy.
If you guys know Ricardo, he'll be very happy. He's very nice.
Okay, so here I've sectioned out that triangle, okay? So this is going to be just kind of like our large block of color that's going to sit out underneath. Again, I had just this bottom, just this base is going to provide, it's too thick. So we're going to come back and right here. So this base here is going to provide a really bright pop that's going to sit underneath, right? And then just having that one slice, that one very fine slice of the all over base color, that's going to break it up just slightly to where then I'm going to alternate the copper and the red over and over all the way up to the top of that triangle.
Katrina asks, do you have anything you can draw your sectioning on? At the moment, during the live, we won't go ahead and do that just because we have a limited amount of time. But afterwards, I'm sure Ricardo can map out his placement for you.
Yeah, I'll make a little something for you, Katrina.
Dustin, the final outcome is going to be an amazingly gorgeous, dimensional, vibrant, yet still natural redhead.
Actually, we're just going to put this away.
You're welcome, Katrina. And just make sure, if you guys aren't following Ricardo on Instagram, where you can DM him and again also see those after results, you can do that on Instagram at Stylist Ricardo Santiago. He also has a Facebook page here, also under Stylist Ricardo Santiago. And then of course you want to make sure you're following along with Cosmo Prof Beauty, Joico, and Joico Intensity,
which if you're watching this, you're probably at least following Cosmo Prof.
I hope so.
Hopefully. So something else that's really cool that just came out this year that I'm pretty excited about because I get to take part in some way, shape, or form is the Cosmo Prof License to Create Awards. If you guys aren't already entered into it, like even if you aren't sure if you have something that's worth, just go for it. Like you never know. You know, you might land yourself a finalist position or a nomination or just get a good nod. But I feel like it's always good to just get exposure whenever you can. And I know the deadline for that is coming up soon. So if you haven't already and you want to be a part of it, definitely, definitely get your submissions in for the License to Create Awards with Cosmo Prof. Because they're going to be having a pretty fantastic show right here in Orlando. So you might just have to find yourself here in the summer in June. Which it's a little hot, but that's okay.
You can hang out with us.
Yeah, you can come hang out with us. You can come and hang out in my studio because it's an open door for anybody most of the time.
We'd show you what it looks like right now, but it's kind of a disheveled mess.
It's all right. Okay, so you can see what I'm doing is I'm just melting that second formula into the first. I personally just like to melt everything now. I feel like It's just a natural progression, right? If you see the way balayage works, the way everything works as far as color melting, It's working from that deeper bass into something lighter, and it's not necessarily a dramatic shift every time, although I do love a beautiful high contrast balayage. And I've been doing a lot of those lately at the shows this year, but I still love just like a very subtle transition. So what you want to do when you're working with this is you want to make sure that you're getting absolute saturation. So I always work in a side-to-side motion, right? And as I'm working, I'm always kind of manipulating the hair with my thumb. So just continuing to separate and saturate and separate and saturate and just keep working that color in until you work your way all the way down through those mids and ends. Because the worst thing that you could do is try to do a beautiful rich red on a blonde and end up with a bunch of holidays. If you end up with a bunch of blonde spots mixed in with a color that's supposed to be as vibrant and rich as this is, it's not gonna look good, right? So that's just kind of a waste. So make sure that you are really saturating really well. And also when working with colors like this, especially when we're gonna be alternating levels, just make sure that you always have a towel handy. So it's a lot of the same concepts as working with fashion shades. You know, a lot of people think that you can only do that with the fashion shades, but I apply this with really every way that I work. Actually, this weekend, I'll be going to Indianapolis doing a small hands-on shop, teaching a little bit more about the way that I color melt, because, like I said, I color melt almost everything. And this could be done at the bowl with a liquid demi, or it could be done in the chair the way that I am, using permanent shades or using the demi creams or using color intensity. It doesn't matter, it will work no matter what, as long as your approach and your saturation is consistent.
We have a question from Lucienne May. How long does the color last, and what aftercare treatment do you recommend? So we kind of touched on that a little bit, but we will go ahead and have Ricardo share again.
Yeah, great question. So she'll get, Lunashine is designed to get up to 30 shampoos, okay, so she will have plenty of longevity with this. Obviously, like we said before, the reds are a little tricky, so anytime you're working with trying to maintain a red, you really want to make sure that you're using something that's color safe. So I would probably recommend, as her daily, Joico's Color Therapy shampoo and conditioner. So it's that gold K-Pack bottle. But it's got the red lettering on it that says Color Therapy, especially because her hair has been quite processed. She has gone through pretty significant lightening, so the K-Pack is going to help to fill that hair back in with all the right proteins that she's going to need and make her hair feel great. But also, in addition to that, I would also recommend the Color Infused Red shampoo and conditioner. So she would probably use that, I would recommend, like every second or third shampoo, just to help to redeposit some of that red. And also the Color Butter as another option, which is a deep conditioning mask that deposits the red color as well.
And then for also Care at Home, you can talk about this.
Oh, yeah.
So this is a brand new product that Joico just launched, in addition to Joico Lusterlock.
That is one of the best products that we've probably ever launched. I have a full-size one here, and this is the second full-size one that I've gone through now in just a month. So every client gets this sprayed on them. This is a Lusterlock multi-perfecting daily shine protecting spray. So this is protecting hair from full spectrum UV protection, UVA, UVB. So it's going to help to prevent fading. It's also going to enrich the hair and give it a lot of brilliant shine. It works great as a detangler. And it's just fantastic to put spray into the hair right after you get them back to the bowl or back to the chair from the shampoo bowl. I just go in and I put this in and then comb through with a detangling brush, and it just slides right through so easy. And it's a great priming base too for when you're gonna cut, and sits at a low pH, so it's a 3 to 4 pH. So that acidic base is gonna help to really close that cuticle back down?
Good questions. And I'll try to post some photos of those products as well so you guys can see them in the comments afterwards. Yeah, that product is pretty amazing. Is this available in Canada? I will save that for our friends managing some of the Joico questions to answer. And that is launching officially and available in May at CosmoProf. But let me, if I may, share that Joico is doing a contest on the Joico and Joico Intensity Instagram. If you click the link in the bio, you can enter to win by taking a quiz on the product and potentially win a free sampling of that product. So definitely check that out.
But you can also, I think right now, if you look in the April shopping guide at your local CosmoProf, which I'm on the cover. It's very awkward for me sometimes when people say, hey, you're on the, but yes, I am on the cover.
Allow me.
And, no.
Hold on, I'm going to sorry guys, hang on.
So on that April shopping guide, if you look inside, there are actually some really fantastic deals. And one of the ones that's in there is for, oh Lord.
Look who's on the cover.
There you go. So one of the ones so that's he's in referencing there, I'm just going to grab it really quick.
And I'll just show you kind of a close-up what's going on in here.
Is this. So this is a great way to get your hands on that product sooner than later, is you can actually get the entire color therapy set.
Bring it
so you've got the color therapy, shampoo, and conditioner. My kink.
Sorry.
So you've got your color therapy, shampoo, and conditioner. You've got your Luster Lock treatment, which is probably the best conditioning mask you'll ever get. And you have a full-size bottle exclusive sneak peek of the Luster Lock spray.
That's
so this
awesome.
Is a great deal. If you get a chance to go to your local CosmoProf or contact your local sales representative and get it.
And be sure to get your autographed copy of
I will not be autographing anything. No.
He's very, very shy about it. He's not shown any pride at all. I've had to brag on him.
It's a big honor and I'm very grateful to Joico and CosmoProf. But if anybody asks me for an autograph, I'll get really weird and I'll run away like a little girl.
We don't want to see that.
You don't want to see me running like a little girl.
Proud wife. Okay, let me see if I missed any questions here. Supermodel on that cover. I agree, Tina. looks like two different guys. Ricardo has been doing some serious work in the gym, so he is doing awesome, awesome. Okay. He's turning red. Yes, he's definitely.
I'm turning red. Okay. I have rosacea.
Okay, so we're coming up on about 10 minutes left. So if you guys have any questions about formulas, about placement, we'll kind of just zoom in here on what Ricardo's doing as he's alternating formulas. If you guys have any questions, this is the time to ask now. Please also feel free, if you found this to be informative or helpful, hey Mel, you can share the live video as well after you're done watching. That would be awesome if you felt like somebody who could benefit from it that missed it, that you can share it on your page and they can check it out afterwards. Where do you enter the contest? Joico is all you use. That's awesome. You can click on the link in Instagram or on Joico and Joico Intensity's Instagram, and that will direct you as to how you can enter to win. The formulas, we'll go ahead and detail those out in the comments and on the posts that are made on social media.
Mm-hmm. Or if you rewatch it and you start from the beginning, I say the formulas like 6 times.
Yeah, you can rewatch it. So that's good. Is he using melting gloves?
Nope, these are just good old fashioned color track gloves. Black
extra
vinyl gloves.
Extra large. One of the only companies XLs. That makes XLs.
I gotta get my XLs.
Will you do?
I have fat fingers.
A part two so we can see the rest.
I wish I could do a part two. I don't know if that's allowed. We'll have to ask CosmoProf because it's very limited space to do these. But we will definitely be posting it on Instagram so you can see it there as well.
Maybe you can kind of just open up some of the
Yeah, so I'm
going
to go on to the other side now.
Okay, so he'll show you some placement.
I want to get to the base of this pyramid before I do. I also wanted to point out, so look, if you see here with that melt, you really shouldn't see any transition lines, right? So it should look pretty fluid, like you're going straight from that darker into that lighter, even though it's very similar. Hey, Lorenzo. So you'll see the way that the colors really melt, and it's a lot easier to identify when you're using color intensity. So obviously, you know, like I said, I do a lot of color intensity melting. And I always say when I'm doing that in a class or on the stage that you want to be able to see a distinct third color being created. So when you put that base color on and then you're putting your second color on, where the two melt, you really should see a third color be created. If you haven't seen that third color, that transition color, then you're not going to get a really fluid melt. So it's really important to make sure that you're saturating, you're using a lot of pressure, a lot of tension in the hair and in the brush to make sure that it's really blurring that color out nicely.
Chrissy Fox from your class that you taught in Holly Hill just said, shout out from your students that you had. It was a great class.
Oh, wow. And that was my Living Garden class.
Yeah. So she wanted to make sure I shouted that out. Okay, well, so.
Thanks for tuning in.
Well, you just told her yourself.
Yeah, never mind.
That
I
works.
Just said it, so
there you go.
Sometimes I don't think before I say stuff.
Okay.
Most of the times I don't think before I say stuff. Okay, so I'm just getting into the base of this here. And then just going to apply that last little bit. Now, the good thing is, like, if I was doing this with intensity and I would feel like that root formula was drying out a little bit, then typically what I would do is come back in with my root formula and just tap. Just put a little bit right at that melt zone, okay? So that way when I come back in, I can apply right over the top. And then if you do that side-to-side motion, you really work that with your fingers, right? And you're really kind of melting that color down. I like to alternate my fingers as well sometimes, so I'll switch as I work my way down. So that way I'm not taking all that pigment from that first melt motion. I don't want to take that all the way down because you're taking the dark too low. So what I'll do is I'll come in with these fingers first, and then I'll switch here as I work a little bit lower, and then I'll switch to my pinky as I get to that last part. So it gives me a nice even melt all the way down.
Those of you who are posting about Ricardo coming to teach in your area, please send a DM. I know he would definitely be interested, right, Ricardo? He loves educating. So send us a DM, and I'm sure that he can make something work out for you.
I love teaching. Yeah. I might just quit working behind a chair and just go teach.
Oh, God. There would be a lot of disappointed Orlando
my clients would hate
residents.
Me. Hopefully none of my clients are watching right now because they saw it on my Facebook. Then they'll start commenting. If you see a bunch of hate comments, it's from them saying the hell you are.
Oh, my God. Okay, so we're going to be wrapping up here in a second. We'll have Ricardo show that, the already applied sections,
mm-hmm.
And just kind of how he alternated the color and separated using Color Track Extra Long Mesh. And Ricardo is using all and only Color Track brushes and bowls, and of course, all Joyco color.
Yep, they're all my friends. Okay, so we're just going to get down to the last of this, and then we're going to jump over to this other side. Actually, we're not going to jump anywhere. I'm just going to spin Callie around.
Mm-hmm.
The chair moves. Why do I have to move? So, let's just get that nice and melted. Nice transition there. And again, the other thing that, like I said in the beginning, is these tones, these colors that we're using, they're only within, like, a level or two of each other, from the deepest being maybe like a 6.5 to the lightest, or maybe a 6 at the deepest to like a 7.5 on the lightest. So everything's going to be very subtle in its dimension. It's going to really just give it a very nice natural blended effect when it's all done. So I'm going to be brave, take my gloves off, get my hands real dirty.
We're just going to take a second here because we're about to wrap up, guys.
We're going to show you this other side real quick.
And again, a few people are saying I'm not on Instagram. Yes, the results will also be shared on Facebook. Not immediately, but give us a day or two and we will share that and make sure that the other pages do as well.
And if you're not on Instagram, shame on you. Get on there. Okay, so let's just spin her around once I get all this mass of hair. Look, this is still
Look how so much hair. Here. This is not even fair.
It's like a full person's head of hair.
That's more than what I have. Just on this
little top section. It's nuts.
That's more than twice my hair. I'm very upset.
She's got like six people's heads on her head. She laughs because she thinks it's funny, but I'm the one doing this, so this is a lot of hair.
She's young. Hey, Mariah.
Okay, so let's just show you. So this underneath, right? So we've got our root melted out into the base. You can see how similar they are. It's just slightly deeper at that root than it is through the mids and ends. And now we're going to get into right where we pass that parallel, right? So I'll lift this on both sides. And you'll see that she has a very red ear. But so we hit that parallel. Okay, so then what I did was I split off and I did one of the intensity red. Okay, so that's just going to give it a really nice bright pop. And then the one over the top of that, this is our formula using our copper mixed in with the NRG as well. Okay, so that kind of matches in with the base on this side. And then when I went over to this front, kind of in between the two quadrants, I alternated. So I went with the copper first, and then I went on with the intensity red. Okay, so same thing, that same base panel. Okay, so, but that's just gonna give it a little bit of a variety between those two. Now, as we got into the triangle portion, the top of the pyramid, if you would, then I just started alternating. So we took a slice of the copper. Sorry, my bra strap is falling.
Oh my God. Apron, not bra strap.
I did a copper, or I'm sorry. So this is our regular base formula, right? This is the same one that we've got going through here. And then we have a copper formulation. And so remember that base formula just slightly separates the two. And then we go from copper to red, to copper, to red, to copper, to the last one actually is going right back onto that base. So that last fine red was the top point of our pyramid because it gets more narrow as we work our way up, and it's just going to provide a little bit more of a fun pop of dimension. And what it's doing too is, if you can see around the face, we're actually just it almost goes right into, I'll turn it a little bit more, so it almost goes right into that hairline right here. So it's just about a half inch off that hairline. So when this hair is laying down, it's really going to start peeking through a little bit, and it's going to add a lot of nice bright pops around her face. So I think we're just about at the end of our rope. I'm going to finish this. This is probably going to take me another hour and a half.
Sorry,
with girl. All this hair. But I wanted to say thank you so much to everyone who tuned in. If you have more questions, please really don't hesitate to reach out and ask me some questions via direct message, whether it's on Facebook or Instagram, either one. I would love to answer as many questions as I can, or just connect with everybody if possible. So again, thank you so much. Thank you to CosmoProf. Thank you to JoyCo. I really appreciate the opportunity. Thank you to my lovely wife for helping out behind the camera. Thank you to my lovely Mao here. And I will be in touch with everybody. I hope to see you all soon. And have a good day. God bless.
Thanks so much, everyone. Have a good evening.